Breaking right now at 6, the FBI confirmed moments ago the remains found yesterday in the Carlton Reserve are, in fact, Brian Laundrie.
They were able to match Brian's dental records to the remains they found yesterday. Soon after they made that confirmation, two officers were at the home of Brian's parents in Northport. You're seeing that right here in this video. They were inside for about 10 minutes. NBC2 has a team of reporters live for you tonight. One is outside the Laundrie home in Northport. But let's start at the Myakkahatchee Park, just 10 minutes north of there. That's where NBC2's Claire Lavazorio has been speaking with the Laundrie family attorney.
Brian Laundrie's parents have been notified that the remains found inside the Carlton Reserve do belong to their son. At this time, they have no further comment and are asking for privacy. Now, we know that this identification has come fairly quickly through dental records. The medical examiner in Sarasota County told us to expect several days of waiting time until that positive identification came forth. So this came fairly quickly. We were able to learn in about 24 hours that what was found inside the Carlton Reserve is in fact remains belonging to Brian Laundrie. Now, agencies today from across the region were here combing through the reserve for any other pieces of evidence that they could find. And I talked with a company called Fly Motion, which brought in several drones that were able to tackle the area from high above, as well as just a few inches off of the ground, to comb for any specific small pieces of evidence to help with this investigation. And they were even able to map out very, very large areas. Take a listen to how this helped aid with their search.
Yeah, that makes it extremely efficient to be able to cover large areas of ground, you know, without having to, you know, put folks that are potentially in harm's way or, you know, put folks around inaccessible areas.
Kelly, Peter, there are obviously still a lot of questions tonight. We don't know how Brian Laundrie died. We also don't know if we will ever find out what happened to his fiance, Gabby Petito. Those are still questions we are hoping to get answered from law enforcement, and we'll keep pressing for those answers tonight. I'm reporting live in Northport, Claire Lavazorio, NBC2.
As mentioned, investigators went to the Laundrie's home, presumably to break the news the remains are in fact their son. They arrived there within the last hour, stayed less than 10 minutes, and left. NBC2 anchor Michael Raimondi has been outside the home all day, where a memorial is growing for Gabby Petito.
We have not seen the Laundrie family coming or going from their home today, but we spoke to some people who want to keep this memorial for Gabby Petito going.
It literally started with this sign and these sticks. That was it. And I'm surprised that it's lasted through all the storms and rain.
These pictures, signs, and flowers in front of the Laundrie home are there to honor Gabby Petito.
People from all over the world had plants delivered here.
Andra Griffin helped create this memorial. Every day for the past month, she's come to chant or sit outside the home.
We wanted to come out here and show force and demand answers and find out what happened to Gabby.
The memorial has grown since Gabby's passing. Griffin is replacing dead flowers and removing signs that are falling apart.
It's been amazing just to see the love and support people have for a person that they never met.
Some flowers and balloons were delivered to the Laundrie house today. Griffin says most of the ones sent here are for Gabby.
You know, we just want a roadside memorial that's as beautiful as Gabby was.
Griffin is hoping to get answers on who killed Petito soon. Until then, she'll be here maintaining this memorial.
I think it's just time to step back. We really want answers.
Reporting in Northport, Michael Raimondi, NBC2.
And we're getting new information daily on this ongoing investigation. In fact, it's coming into our newsroom by the minute. So if we learn anything new, we will be the first to let you know.
Yeah, we'll come on air. We'll update you also on the NBC2 News app and our website.